angle. Now we can see here, intensity is almost constant, and suddenly for particular angle there is increase, sharp increase in intensity, or we get a peak here. Then again for next value of theta, again we get a peak here. So we get certain peaks. Now these peaks show the maximum value of intensity. So we can say that at this value of theta we get maximum intensity. It means the condition for bright is satisfied. And condition for bright, it means Bragg's law. So we can say that at the position of these peak values of theta, Bragg's condition is satisfied. So this is the Bragg's condition, 2d sin theta equal to lambda. We take n equal to 1 because we record the reading only for first order. Now from this graph, we know the value of theta. We know the value of lambda, that is wavelength of X-ray. So from this equation, we can find the value of D for different values of theta, and we can find this ratio. We can see here 1 upon D1 is to 1 upon D2 is to 1 upon D3. It corresponds to sin theta 1 is to sin theta 2 is to sin theta 3. Now, for example, consider simple cubic crystal. Now see here, this is simple cubic crystal, and see this plane, it is 1, 0, 0. Now the next plane is 1, 1, 0, and next plane is 1, 1, 1. So these planes 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. These planes in simple cubic are rich in atom, number of atoms, and they give Bragg's reflection. Now we know the formula, D is equal to A upon root of H square plus K square plus L square. Using this formula, where A is the lattice parameter, we get D1 equal to A in this case. For 110 planes, D2 is equal to A by root 2, and 111 planes, D3 is equal to A by root 3. So if we find the ratio, see here, 1 upon D1 is to 1 upon D2 is to 1 upon D3. See here, A will get cancelled, and we get 1 is to root 2 is to root 3. It is for simple cubic. It should be D3. Then it is 1 is to 1 by root 2 is to root 3 for BCC, body centered cubic lattice, and 1 is to root 2 is to root 3 by 2 for face centered cubic or FCC lattice. Now why do we get the change in these values? It is because for simple cubic we have these planes, but for BCC and FCC additional atomic planes are there. Like this is the 200 plane, this is 220 plane, and 222 plane. Now these 100 and these 200 planes, they are out of phase. If we consider BCC and FCC, this 100 and 200 planes are out of phase, and by destructive interference, the reflection from 100 plane is cancelled. So for BCC lattice, the planes that are responsible for Bragg's reflection are 110, means this plane 110, 200 and 211. And for FCC lattice, it is 111, 200 and 222. These planes are responsible for Bragg's reflection, and so we get the ratio like this. Okay. Now consider one example, KCl crystal. So if we perform the experiment for KCl crystal, so we get three values of theta that give maximum intensity, that is 5.22 degree, 7.3 degree, and 9.05 degree. Now, if we put these values in this equation, we get 1 is to root 2 is to root 3. Now, we know this is the formula for simple cubic. So, we can say that KCL is simple cubic. Now, actually, we know KCL is FCC, but there is a limitation of this particular exponent. Other complicated calculations are there that we have not considered. We have considered very basic calculations, and so it gives simple cubic structure. Okay. Now, Bragg's condition 2d sin theta equal to n lambda is very important condition, but it is not the only condition. Okay. Now, such a data is available for all the crystals like JCPDS, ICDD. This is Joint Committee for Powder Diffraction Standards. This committee was formed in 1941, and now in 1978 it is called as, or it is renamed as, International Center for Diffraction Data. And such a data is available for thousands of materials, and that data regarding X-ray diffraction of these materials reveals the values of the interplanar distance and relative intensities, and we compare our data with this JCPDS data. Okay. Now, Bragg's reflection is not the only condition. It means for some crystals, even if the Bragg's condition 2d sin theta equal to n lambda satisfied, then also that plane doesn't give maximum intensity. Means along with Bragg's condition, some other conditions must be satisfied to get the maximum intensity in diffraction pattern. So we can consider only cubic crystal. Now for simple cubic crystal, there is no such specific condition. All planes are possible. Means all planes that give Bragg's reflection. For BCC, all the planes will not give reflection. The condition is H plus K plus L must be even. Means if we consider 1, 1, 0, then H plus K plus 1, L is 2. So this plane is possible. Now 1, 2, 3, we get the total as 6. So this plane is also possible. Now see 1, 1, 1, the addition is 3. It is odd number. So this plane is not possible. It will not give Bragg's reflection in case of BCC. Now if it is FCC, the condition is all the HKL values must be either odd or even. For example, see 1, 1, 1, all are odd, so it is possible, this plane is possible. 2, 2, 0, all are even, so this plane is also possible. But 1, 0, 0 plane, here 1 is odd, but 0, 0 we consider even, so this plane is not possible. Okay. Now consider our example. This is the graph that we get in our experiment. Now, on this basis of BCC, FCC, we analyze this graph. Now, when we see all the peaks in the graph, all the peaks we have to consider, not only one peak. Now, consider the first peak, 1, 1, 1. See, all are odd. Now, consider the second peak, 2, 0, 0, means all are even. Third, 2, 2, 0, means again all are even. Next, 3, 1, 1, all odd, all even, means the condition for FCC is satisfied. And therefore, what is the crystal structure? It is FCC. One more example we will see here. X-rays are diffracted by the planes 110, 220, 300 in crystal. So what is the crystal structure? So every plane we consider now 1 1 0. So if we consider 1 1 0, see these are odd figures, so this is the even, so it cannot be FCC. But 1 plus 1 2, it means it can be BCC. Now we consider the next plane 2 2 0. It also satisfied condition for BCC. Next 3 0 0. It doesn't satisfy condition for BCC. Means two planes satisfy condition for BCC, but next plane, third plane, does not satisfy condition for BCC, so it cannot be BCC. So it neither satisfy condition for FCC nor for BCC. So what is the conclusion? It is simple cubic or primitive lattice. Simple cubic is also called as a primitive. So this crystal is primitive lattice. Thank you, friends. Thank you very much.